In terms of equipment, we have more than it takes to get to this fight. In terms of human resource, we have more than the numbers we need, except we may need some bit of retraining and orientation on COVID-19. If we get this lab running for COVID, it's going to relieve the stress on UVRI should we have an escalation of this epidemic. The other justification, of course, you see, it takes about 6 hours plus to for sample to be taken from Gulu or from the region to UVRI. And those 6 hours, if we had the machines here, would have got results same day. It's worse off for distant, more distant places like Karua. So I think for the greater north, the eastern and the midwest, southern Uganda, all this belt can benefit from this facility.
We still emphasize that let us decentralize this testing. I know the use of gene expert is coming up, but at the moment that is not yet functional. Still, we can have another center like Uganda Virus Institute, Gulu University, having all these equipment. The government and other partners should ensure that this laboratory should be uplifted so that we can test COVID-19 and even look ahead for other viral hemorrhagic fever like Ebola. We may still get, after this COVID, another outbreak that can become even pandemic.
And the request is to just have about $700,000 to put the necessary facilities needed to upgrade. And we are informed this can be done within a period of 2 weeks once the resources are available.
When we upgrade this to the level we are talking about, there can be a lot of research work, research and development that these medical students, especially at graduate levels, especially PhDs, they'll greatly benefit from this facility. And this will benefit the entire country and the greater region. So we think this lab will not only go for in the control of this virus, but it's also going to go a long way for uplifting our levels of training, especially at graduate, postgraduate training, masters and PhDs.